Kim, your website's up.
Okay, so I'm all ready to go. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I want to thank Jennifer and Judy, Saeed, Elizabeth, Greg, and Michael for all making this possible, and particularly being flexible enough to allow me to present remotely this afternoon. I just want to touch really briefly on the sort of genesis of this project, specifically from the Black Press perspective. I'm going to talk about digital scholarship or digital work on the Black Press just very briefly. And then I'll just walk you through the website and talk a little bit about the project. I know Saeed will talk about the process and the workflows, and Elizabeth will contribute the perspective of the Hopkins Press. So my perspective today is to largely come from a scholar's perspective, which you'll hear from all three of us is obviously an integral part of the project as well as the process of publication. So I just again want to touch on the history of the Black Press just to orient people in terms of the project. And I want to start off with a quote from Henry Louis Gates, who states that the history of the Black Press is, quote, almost a self-contained universe of thought and feelings of the African-American people, their aspirations and dreams, but also their everyday concerns and occurrences. And so that quote, I like to lead off that quote because it suggests how instrumental and how fundamental the Black Press has been to not just people of African descent in the United States, but fundamental to reinforcing the democratic ideals on which United States society was founded. And so the term Black Press really refers to a serial print newspapers that were published and are still published today by Black-owned businesses, and truly represents one of the most radical newspaper traditions in the United States. And scholars of the 20th century of American society, and specifically of African Americans, undertook the arduous process of looking through bound volumes of newspapers and microfilm reels to recover the history of African Americans in newspapers. And now today, in the 21st century, scholars have the luxury of digitized newspapers, full-text searching, and electronic databases. Yet, despite the presence of all the digital innovation and allowing us to access newspapers, scholarship in the Black Press remains limited and underutilized, underexamined. And so there's a large gap in what is available in the Black Press digitally and even in print. And so I would argue that this lack of access occurs for two reasons. The lack of accessibility of digitized newspapers, which some of the most important ones remain behind firewalls, and the absence of digital scholarship that allow people to really understand the significance and the impact of the Black Press. And that's the genesis of this project in many ways. This idea that in the digital era, students and scholars should expect to locate scholarly resources on the Black Press that live exclusively online, and definitely more scholarship that's coming out in traditional formats like print. And at the moment, at the present moment, they can't. But the Black Press Born Digital hopes to change that as it transforms digitized newspapers into coherent and innovative narratives that create a deeper significance of the history of the Black Press. So this project, in its broadest sense, and I'm going to start walking through the website a little bit, is to create innovative digital scholarship and resources on the Black Press that's accessible both via the digital and the print format. And so more specifically, the project started with an ACLS grant, American Council of Alerted Societies grant, that was a digital innovation grant that was designed to give or provide resources or the impetus for some sort of digital innovation on a topic or idea. And that morphed into a collaborative relationship between Johns Hopkins University Press and Sheridan's Libraries and the scholars. And what this project is, in a nutshell, is it's a project that will produce four short peer-reviewed open access and searchable born digital books on transnationalism in the early Black Press, short story fiction in the Black press. Children of the Civil Rights Generation and the Chicago Defender. And then finally, political cartoons from Muhammad Speaks, a radical Black newspaper of the 1960s and 70s. And unlike this other digital books, I would say, the digital book is not secondary to the print. And I think that's what makes this so innovative, is that instead of seeing the digital as a sort of another edition or just an e-version of a print book, the Black Press for Digital Book Project sees the digital as a way to conceptualize a new type of publication, a new way to communicate scholarly, and that the print is not necessarily secondary to the digital, but they sort of work in tandem together. And in some ways they look similar, but in many ways they will not look exactly similar also. In this sense, the Born Digital books are not surrogates for the print books. They animate the valuable role that the Black press has historically played in American history, and they build on moved or driven by the collaboration between the academic press, the library, and then the scholar. And so there is a wonderful group of people who are working together as a team. That include myself and Greg Britton and Elizabeth, Saeed, Mark Sizek, and Chella Hanavu, who are all part and parcel of how this project will develop. And then this group works with the authors, who are all scholars of the Black press, Benjamin Fagan, who's a scholar at Auburn University, myself at Purdue, Maura Hinder, who's an independent scholar, but who is affiliated with Johns Hopkins also, and then Kerem Hussein, who is a scholar at Hobart and William Smith Colleges in Geneva and New York. Couple last things, and then I'll wrap up. One of the main things, and this is, I think, a great segue into Saeed's presentation, is that this project sees the library as a publishing hub, if you will, right? And so it draws on this idea by envisioning the academic library as the main conduit to publishing and disseminating born digital books. I think this model is the model is best exemplified, or one of the best models for this is the Michigan publishing at the University of Michigan Library, where the library acts as the hub of scholarly publishing. But it was Saeed, and I'll let him talk a little bit more about this, who wanted the academic press to be very much a part of it, and saw the academic press and the scholarly, the scholars, and then the library all working together as a partner in the scholarly publishing process. And so while other academic libraries have considered open access publishing journals, the BDP project attempts to go beyond this idea in an effort to focus on digital monographs. So I think I'll stop there and then have Saeed pick it up. And if there are any questions about the project from the scholar's perspective, I'd be more than happy to take those questions during the Q&A.
Thanks, Kim.